Welcome to this Educator preparation video for the Space Jam A New Legacy Coding Workshop, a two-part lesson for students ages 8 and up. This is the second of two prep videos included with this curriculum. This video is a walkthrough of the coding tutorial to help you build familiarity and confidence with the platform, concepts, and tutorial steps before guiding students through the activity. This tutorial is available online at aka.ms/chase-the-basketball. The first step of this tutorial is to check out this GIF of the finished game and read what it's about. In this Microsoft MakeCode Arcade tutorial, you'll use block-based code to create a game with two sprites, a player and a basketball. In 2D game design, sprites are the characters and objects you can control and interact with. In MakeCode Arcade, you can use code to make sprites talk, move, and more. The goal of this game is to chase and catch the basketball sprite as it moves around the game screen. Each time the player catches the basketball, you get points and the countdown restarts. In step 2, you add your first block of code. Open the Scene toolbox drawer and drag the Set Background Image block into the On Start block in your workspace. If you accidentally grab the wrong block, you can drag it left to delete it. As you add blocks, they snap into place just like puzzle pieces. Now that we've placed the background block, let's set the image. First, we select this little box. Then we switch from the editor to the gallery and select the Space Jam A New Legacy basketball court. As you add blocks, the game simulator will update in real time. You can also refresh it by selecting this button. Now let's make our player sprite. From the sprites drawer, grab the first block, Set My Sprite, and drop it into the On Start block. If at any point you want help figuring out the step, you can select the blue light bulb icon to get a hint. The next step is to choose an image for our player. Scroll down in the gallery to choose your favorite Space Jam A New Legacy character. Or you can draw your own player. But for the sake of time, we recommend holding off on game customization like this until the class has completed the tutorial. Now we're going to make our player move with a Move My Sprite with Buttons block. Once you add this block, try moving your player with the game simulator controls or with the arrows on your keyboard. Next, we need to create our basketball. This time it will be My Sprite 2. Now we need to set the kind. It's not a player sprite and these other options aren't quite right. So let's select Add a New Kind and type in basketball. Next, we choose our sprite image, just like we did with the player. At this point, we have our two sprites on the game background and our player moves. Now we need to add code that makes things happen when our player sprite overlaps with the basketball sprite. For that, we need the OnSpriteOverlapsOtherSprite block. You can place this anywhere on the workspace. Now we need to specify what kind of overlap we're talking about. We want something to happen when our player overlaps with the basketball, so we need to change this second kind to basketball. Next, we need to specify what should happen when this overlap occurs. Let's add points to the score. Go to the Info drawer and drag Change Score into the Overlap block. Great! Right now it's very easy to score points because the basketball doesn't move. Let's change that. To make the game more fun, we can set the basketball to go to a random position on the screen. To do that, we have to specify which sprite we're talking about here. Next, we'll use the pick random blocks to create random coordinates on the game screen. We'll need two. One for the X or horizontal coordinate, and one for the Y or vertical coordinate. If your students know about or are learning about coordinates in math, this is a great way to reinforce or introduce that idea. The arcade game screen is a grid 160 pixels wide and 120 pixels high. We want our basketball to appear randomly on the screen, not outside of it where we can't see it. So we need to set these X and Y ranges accordingly. Now we have a working game. Every time we catch the basketball, we earn a point. And it moves to a new random position. We can make the game a little harder with a time countdown. Because all this code is triggered each time the player and basketball overlap, the countdown will restart each time. And now we have a complete game that's fun to play. That's the end of the tutorial. Students can publish their project and get a link they can share with the class or their friends and family. If your students finish this lesson early or you'd like to extend the lesson, there are lots of fun challenges and customization opportunities. There are many blocks beyond what we used in the tutorial. For example, you can choose different sprites. Or draw your own. The same goes for the background image. You can make the game more challenging by reducing the countdown time. You can make it easier by making your player move faster. You can make your player talk, add effects, and even add sounds. There are a lot of fun things to experiment with, and many more great MakeCode Arcade tutorials to explore at arcade.makecode.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great lesson.